And still on the allegations of looting in the NDDC, we are also joined now by legal practitioner and social commentator Liborous Oshomah. Good morning, Liborous.
Yeah, good morning.
And it's good to have you this Monday morning.
My pleasure.
You had a conversation with a senior advocate of Nigeria, Femi Falana, there. What's your thoughts on all of this that is unfolding?
Spot on. My only addition is the fact that it's even under PDP, you know, the story was indifferent. And so, unfortunately, now people see NDDC as a commission created for them to, you know, come chop instead of a commission, you know, for the development of Niger Delta. And so some people now feel that once their pockets and their personal estate is developed, that's a development of the Niger Delta. And that's the unfortunate part of it. And that's why, just like OMPADEC, NDDC also has taken the same dimension and direction, where somebody, you know, is paid ₦1 billion to install a signboard. And then where, you know, you award contracts for the same thing on the same day to two different companies,
right,
where you spend ₦10.2 billion to sensitize people against COVID-19, where the Senate budgets $800 million for rehabilitation of roads, and within 6 months, you spend $26 billion instead of $800 million. Then you now go back to Senate to ask for vehement. You know, so it's where you spend, you know, $1.5 billion to train people on welding, and then you now begin to wonder how much do you now need to give them to start, you know, welding in itself. You know, so when you now have an interim committee, like the Learned Sikh has said, that is not accountable to anybody,
right,
and whose tenure is open-ended, who are allegedly supposed
open-ended.
To...
Open-ended, what do you mean by
open-ended,
that?
You're just there. You don't know when they will leave. It's at the pleasure of Mr. President or the minister who supposedly is acting. You know, and so that's why you hear juicy ministry and non-juicy ministry.
And that takes me, okay, sorry, not to cut you short, because I was going to say, that takes me to my next question. This alleged looting did not just happen overnight. It's not what happened yesterday, and we're talking about it this morning. How come details are only emerging now?
It's always been there. It's always been there. And that's why I told you, I said, it is not just happening now. Even under PDP, it was the same thing. Go check all previous NDDC, you know, directors, chairmen, MDs, there's always been one allegation of financial impropriety against them. And in some cases, you know, people are appointed directors to this board, you know, to rehabilitate them financially. In some cases, you know, they are left there, contracts are awarded, and then the funds, the contracts are not executed, the funds are used to prosecute election. And that's why I say that some persons now see the commission as a come chop organization to develop their personal estate and not to develop the Niger Delta. And then it's now so unfortunate where you now have an interim management committee whose tenure is open-ended, you know, according to the dictator of whoever appointed them. And we also have seen how government, previous, past and present, have audited the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation, NNPC. They've never appointed an interim management committee to audit an NPC. You don't need an interim management committee to audit any government organization. All you need is either a forensic financial auditor, or you ask the office of the Auditor General of the Federation to do the auditing. And then, not just to audit and, you know, smoke up revelation, once anybody is found culpable, the persons and persons should be made to face the music. Here, the problem here is that, you know, there are no consequences for any actions or inaction. And so, the moment you know that you can easily get away with whatever you do, whether you steal or not, and then some of these jobs are seen as compensation for political allies and cronies.
Mm-hmm.
And it becomes very easy. So that's why you see people jostling for this board's appointment, and then a new minister comes, he wants to put his men. The former MD of the board, Esima Ekere, was deputy governor under Akpabio. Akpabio was in PDP, we were both in PDP then,
right?
You know, before he crossed over. And there were allegations also that that board also, that white board was the board sacked. Why did they bring interim committee? All in the pretense to clean the Ojan table. If it wasn't bad, nobody would be thinking of cleaning it. So it has always been bad from beginning. It has never, the NDDC had never from inception achieved the aim, the purpose for which it was set up. I had expected, like the Sladen Sikh said, a commission that is set up for the development to compensate for the degradation in the Niger Delta.
Mm.
If you feel anything had gone wrong, you don't wait for years to audit. Yes, it's good. As soon as you come on board, you audit every organization. Before you even appoint a new management, a new board, there should be, you know,
take a look.
Forensic auditing, but not by what you call it, interim committee that is unknown to law. You appoint NMPC, they audit NMPC regularly. So you don't need an interim management to come head the NMPC. People who also are looking for rehabilitation, people who joined your political parties because they are looking for something to chop.
Mm.
And so the moment you now begin to put them in these places, what are they going to do? They see such opportunity as opportunity to further their ownness. Mind you, they are all interested in political offices. And the only way they can raise funds to prosecute election is to head some of these boards that are not accountable to anybody. And that's why you see this back and forth with the Senate. Now, the auditor is being audited.
Right. Now, but again, what this is pointing towards, or the obvious question would be, for such huge amount of money to be, you know, allegedly diverted, it seemed to be there are other, co-conspirators in this matter. Why
are
not?
There are many. Like
you're
I told
almost
you.
Set before.
Yes, yes. Because I have done extensive study on this, and like I told you, Kayode Justice, Kayode Esho, Justice of the Supreme Court, once said that behind every allegation of corruption against a judge, there's a senior advocate who is a conveyor belt.
Oh, wow.
Behind every allegation of financial impropriety against directors, members of the board of a company, or members of interim management committee, there are people, contractors, in some cases, political office holders who are conveyor belts. And you find out that some of these contracts are not just awarded to anybody on the street. You can't just bid and qualify for it. I've been part of this, some of these processes. We have even, you know, had to write petitions to the National Assembly. You lobby, you settle for it. And so that's why I said that there needs to be not just an auditing. There needs to be that willpower to actually want to do something, to actually want to make the organization to achieve the aim for which it was set up. Once you have that willpower, irrespective of whose horse is God, you'll be able to do the job neatly. First and foremost, let there be an audit. Once there's an audit, people who are culpable, give the EFCC, the ICPC, the marching order to ensure that prosecution is done timeously, and not this open-ended kind of prosecution where, you know, you have all kind of adjournment. Thank God, with the Administration of Criminal Justice Act, you can, you know, prosecute criminal matters, you know, adjournment can be done on a daily basis. And so once you do that, you use some of these persons to set example. And any other audit that subsequently follows, anybody found culpable, whether in your party or outside your party, let those people be made to face the music. The moment you do that, it will be obvious. You would have shown not just strength of character, that you are truly ready to fight corruption, but any other person coming will understand that your body language that people so talk about is not just a body language of all sounds and no action.
Mm-hmm.
They will be convinced that, look, I know that if I do this, the president or the minister will not be happy, mm-hmm. and I would be made to face the music, and my family name might even be destroyed in the process. But when you know that you can come on board award contract of billions, and then even when you're arrested by EFCC, you settle your way through, you get to court, you bribe your way through, and then you can get, you know, some big senior advocate to represent you and then drag the matter ad infinitum, then you can do whatever you like. And that's why you find out that there have been accusations. The IMC also had accused the former board members that contracts were awarded for distribution of chairs, and that their audit also revealed that those chairs found their way back to the store or to the shop for which they were purchased. Mm-hmm. When you find such allegations, do you just go public and say, oh, there are names, there are senators who were awarded contract and they didn't do anything? But this, for me, at the end of the day, becomes a media war. What you should do the moment your investigation reveals such, you take up the matter with EFCC. You immediately send a petition to EFCC to look into these allegations and possibly initiate prosecution. But a situation where you come on air and just say, oh, our investigation revealed this, mm-hmm. oh, some senators. And the senators are also saying that your own act and action now, you know, there's so monumental corruption underneath what you're doing. And so there's need for them also to oversight the activities of the board. And then you say, no, you. Then it raises questions. Mm-hmm. And then you now become, the hunter becomes the hunted.
Yeah, but the problem is, Liborous, even as I hear you try to explain all of this, is it looks like beneath all of this is an encouragement of the culture of impunity.
Yes.
So who is supposed to question all of this? Or who is supposed to drag most, you know, in the strongest way possible to see that we are not headed the same way all the time?
I have been saying it, maybe I have not been saying it loud, and you want me to begin to mention it, Mr. President, the box stop at his table. Because when people voted massively for Buhari in 2015, even though they didn't believe in, you know, so many people that were with him, but they felt that he had the whipper, mm-hmm. to fight corruption and put a stop to this, and that the first thing he was going to do was to appoint people of like minds to work with him. Let's assume that political parties drove the process in 2015. By 2019, mm-hmm. he probably has a footing. What has he done since then? When your body language, you know, is that encourages impunity and without consequences, people are going to ride roughshod on you. And that's what basically is happening. If Mr. President had put his foot down to say, no, I need this done and I need report feedback on it. Look at the case of COVID-19. Every day we're inundated with report from the presidential committee. Why are we not so inundated with reports on insecurity, on the issues of corruption? It's as if you just set up committee and you look the other way and you expect them to have the same mind with you. What yield result is monitoring and enforcement of sanctions. When there are no monitoring, laws are subject to abuse, and massive abuse. And like they say, when you now give a body that is unknown to law absolute power, definitely you'll be aware that such powers will corrupt them absolutely.
Right.
And so that's why you have an interim management committee that is so immersed in corruption, in sleaze. Meanwhile, they were supposed to come and clean up the alleged corruption that have been committed. And as we speak, no one person is being investigated. No one person is being prosecuted. What does that tell you?
So where are we headed in the end?
Nowhere. And then the minister talks tough. I read in the news this morning where the deputy senate president is saying that he did not order the senate to investigate the minister. What is wrong if the deputy senate president actually feels uncomfortable with the activities of the Niger Delta Development Commission? He is from Niger Delta, and if he feels uncomfortable with the financial activities, he has the inherent powers as a senator, not just as deputy senate president, as a senator, to order the auditing or to ask the committee that is responsible for oversighting the Niger Delta to look into the activities to ensure that it is redirected. And so, but because we want to play politics with everything, oh, it wasn't me. And so we begin to, you know, it becomes a ping pong. You now hear of witch hunting, mm-hmm. or persecution. And then we now leave the main issue, which is financial sleaze, going on in a commission that is meant to benefit the people. Once that happens and nobody's prosecuted, what you're going to find is that tomorrow when the next person comes, he will just simply borrow a book from the precedent that have been laid, mm-hmm. and it becomes business as usual.
And there's nothing that will change.
There's not, things can change. Like the learned seeker said, a lot can change. Mm-hmm. If the people, I always say this, the people should understand that they are the ones in opposition. The moment we all understand that we are the ones in opposition, not the PDP shouting foul now, when they were there, they did the same thing. And not mm-hmm. the APC today. If we understand that we, who are supposed to be beneficiaries of this commission, are the ones in opposition, and we stand tall and insist that the right thing must be done, then politicians, who are few, will do the right thing. But if we always are divided by, oh, which party is he talking from, which mm-hmm. party does he belong to, who is he supporting in the next election, once you are a supporter of Buhari, he can do no wrong in your eyes. And once you are not a supporter of Buhari, everything he does is wrong, then they will continue to divide and rule us. And that's basically what is playing out here.
Interesting. Thank you very much, Liborous.